Welcome to Link G4x Training Part 49. In this video, we're going to be taking a look at our diagnostic output capability within our PCLink software. So if we're trying to test an output from our G4x box, we might suspect that we have a bad coil or a bad injector, or the output wiring isn't wired properly to turn a fuel pump on or a fan on. We can test that output with our software and actually override any of the programming conditions so we can verify if that feature or function is being controlled properly. Is it a wiring problem? Is it actually the component that's bad? Do we have a bad ignition coil? Do we have a bad injector? I'm going to show you the couple of different variations we have here for testing so you understand how to work with that and how to implement that if you have any kind of actual issues and you're doing troubleshooting. Without further wait, let's jump in so we can check this out. Okay, so let's get started. We're going to be taking a look at working with our diagnostic testing output capability within our Link G4x systems. I wanted to do a quick video here just to touch on these subjects of how we can go and test our outputs to make sure that you know that it's available in the software and know how to go proceed with the testing features if you're suspecting that maybe an injector's not firing or a coil's not firing or an output isn't working properly, or if you want to go and test a custom engine harness before you install it into the actual vehicle, we can use our test output features and capabilities here to make sure that the wiring is correct so that when we install the custom engine harness into the car, everything's going to work properly and we can immediately fire up the engine and start our calibration process. The first thing I want to go over here is taking a look at our injector test. This is going to allow us to go and command the injector to pulse to verify that the injector itself is actually working properly. So if we go here to injector test, we have some options. We find that we have our injectors 1 through 8. So in this particular box I'm working with, which is an extreme G4X, I have 8 total injector drivers, which is why we have all these available. If you're working with a lower tiered box that only has 4 injector outputs, you'll find that it'll just be for injectors 1 through 4. So in this case here, if I wanted to go and test my injector output number 1, we can find if I select this option here, it's going to be going in and pulsing my injector at a 2 millisecond pulse width for 10 Hertz. So it's gonna be doing 2 milliseconds every 10 times every second. So 10 Hertz signifies how many times per second it'll be doing that pulse. So by going here and selecting okay, that's gonna start to run my injector again at 2 milliseconds for 10 times over a second and pulse that injector. It's gonna continuously do that until we actually go here and select it to the off. So it's going to continuously send that pulse output. Now when we go and do the injector test and we select our options 1 through 8 here, or advanced test injection 1 here, it's going to go in and turn off our fuel pump. And that's actually going to be desirable. We don't want to build fuel pressure if we're doing an injector test, because if we have fuel pressure behind the injector as it's pulsing, it's going to be pumping that fuel into the engine and we'll find we could fill up the engine and hydrolock the engine because we have the entire cylinder filled with fuel. So if you're going to be doing this particular test, I would recommend to take the injector out of the fuel rail, connect it to the wire harness, and then do your test to make sure that the injector itself actually pulses so we don't run the risk of going in and actually spraying fuel into the engine during that test. Even though the fuel pump might be off, we'll find in that condition it can still go in. If there's residual fuel pressure in the rail, which a lot of times there will be, it'll still pump all the available fuel pressure, all the available fuel flow from the fuel rail into that cylinder, which is still way too much fuel, and can flood it out. So just for a warning and a kind of a heads up. And we do have the other option here, the advanced test injection 1. If we select this option here, the below parameters are going to apply. So we can specify how many times we want the injector to pulse, the frequency, or how many times per second we want it to pulse at, and then the total pulse width we wanted to pulse at. So
thanks for checking out our teaser clip. If you want to see the rest of this video and more than 500 hours of current EFI training we have to offer, make sure you click right here. If you want to go and check out more teaser clips from this training course, click here. And you don't want to miss any of the videos we're going to be releasing on this channel, so make sure you subscribe and click here. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys later.